The Mark IV was a British tank of the First World War. Introduced in 1917, it benefited from significant developments of the Mark I tank, the intervening designs being small batches used for training. The main improvements were in armor, the resighting of the fuel tank and ease of transport. A total of 1,220 Mk4 were built, 420 males, 595 females, and 205 tank tenders, unarmed vehicles used to carry supplies, which made it the most numerous British tank of the war. The Mark IV was first used in mid-1917 at the Battle of Messines Ridge. It remained in British service until the end of the war, and a small number served briefly with other combatants afterwards. The Renault FT, frequently referred to in post-World War I literature as the FT-17, FT-17, or similar, was a French light tank that was among the most revolutionary and influential tank designs in history. The FT was the first production tank to have its armament within a fully rotating turret. The Renault FT's configuration, crew compartment at the front, engine compartment at the back, and main armament in a revolving turret, became and remains the standard tank layout. Consequently, some armored warfare historians have called the Renault FT the world's first modern tank. Over 3,000 Renault FT tanks were manufactured by France, most of them in 1918. After World War I, FT tanks were exported in large numbers. Copies and derivative designs were manufactured in the United States, M1917 light tank, in Italy, Fiat 3000, and in the Soviet Union, T-18 tank. The Renault FT saw combat during the interwar conflicts around the world but was considered obsolete at the outbreak of World War II. The Sturmpanzerwaffen A7V was a heavy tank introduced by Germany in 1918 during World War I. 100 chassis were ordered in early 1917, 10 to be finished as fighting vehicles with armored bodies, and the remainder as Überlandwaffen cargo carriers. The number to be armored was later increased to 20. They were used in action from March to October 1918, and were the only tanks produced by Germany in World War I to be used in combat, as well as being the first operational German tank. It was developed as a response to British tanks. Although the A7V is generally considered to be better designed compared to its counterparts, it struggled to procure high production numbers due to its relative complexity and high cost. The medium Marke Whippet was a tank employed by the British in World War I. Intended for fast mobile assaults, it was intended to complement the slower British heavy tanks by using its relative mobility and speed in exploiting any break in the enemy lines. Although the track design appears more modern than the British tank's Mark I to V, it was directly derived from Little Willie, the first tank prototype, itself directly taken from the track design of the Holt tractor, and was unsprung. The crew compartment was a fixed, polygonal turret at the rear of the vehicle, and two engines of the type used in contemporary double-decker buses were in a forward compartment, driving one track each. The Sturmpanzerwaffen Oberschlesien, Assault Tank Upper Silesia, from German, Der Sturm, the Assault, German, Der Panzerwagen the Tank, was a German tank project of the First World War. It was a radical design for a fast-moving, lightly armored assault tank. The Oberschlesien included a track which was placed under the tank and only wrapped around half of it. The design sacrificed armor for the sake of speed and only required a 180 horsepower, 130 kilowatts engine for the 19-ton body, giving it a projected ground speed of 16 kilometers per hour, 9.9 miles per hour. The tank featured such advanced features as the main armament mounted on top of the tank in a centrally placed revolving turret, separate fighting and engine compartments, a rear-mounted engine and a low track run. The Leichter Kampfwagen II, light combat vehicle, commonly known as the LK2, was a light tank designed and produced in limited numbers in Germany in the last year of World War I. A development of the LKI, it incorporated a fixed rear superstructure and had two distinct configurations, one variant being armed with the MG08/15, and the other being armed with a 5.7 cm Maxim Nordenfeldt gun. Its armor was 8 to 14 mm thick, which led to a total weight of 8.75 tons. Power was provided by a Daimler-Benz Model 1910 four-cylinder 55 to 60 horsepower gasoline engine, giving a maximum speed of 14 to 18 kilometers per hour with range of 65 to 70 kilometers. The LK2 was designed by German engineer and automobile designer Joseph Vollmer, who also designed the A7V, the K-Wagon, and the LKI. Vollmer was appointed to the position of chief designer for the German War Department's motor vehicle section. Only two prototypes were produced by June 1918, and were followed by orders for 580 tanks, which were never completed. The Leichter Kampfwagen, English, light combat car, or LKI, was a German light tank prototype of the First World War. Designed to be a cheap light tank as opposed to the expensive heavies coming into service at the time, the tank only reached the prototype stage before the end of the war. The LK1 was designed by Joseph Vollmer. It was based on a Daimler car chassis, using the existing axles to mount sprocket and idler wheels. Its design followed automobile practice, with a front-mounted engine and a driving compartment behind it. It was the first German armored fighting vehicle to be equipped with a turret, armed with a 7.92 mm MG-08 machine gun. Only two prototypes were produced in mid-1918, but no vehicles were ordered. Designed as an experimental cavalry tank, it paved the way to the LK2. In June 1917, before the first A7V tanks had been completed, the German War Ministry ordered the development of a new super-heavy tank intended to be used in breakthrough situations. Design work was carried out by Joseph Vollmer, a reserve captain and engineer working for the Verkehrstechnische Prüfungskommission, Transport Technologies Board of Examiners, of the Army, and a Captain Wieger. On June 28, 1917, the War Ministry approved the draft design and ordered 10 examples, 5 to be built by the Reed Ball Bearing Factory in Berlin and 5 by Wegmann and Company of Kassel. The vehicle originally weighed 165 tons, but this was reduced to a more practicable 120 tons by shortening the length. The huge size and mass of the K-Wagon made it impossible to transport complete, so it was decided that it would be split into 4 sections for transport by rail, to be reassembled behind the front line near where it was to be used. 2 prototypes were built at the request of Hindenburg, but were still incomplete by the end of the war due to lack of raw materials and other demands for weaponry. The Leichttraktor was a German experimental tank. After the end of World War I, Germany was restricted in military development by the Treaty of Versailles. However, it was developed in a secret program under the cover name Traktor. Its engine was mounted inside the front portion of the hull and the turret was mounted above the fighting compartment in the rear of the tank. Both Rheinmetall and Krupp produced prototypes, and in 1928, Rheinmetall's design was chosen and was awarded an order for 289 tanks. However, some time later, the order was cancelled. Krupp models had coil spring suspensions, while Rheinmetall had leaf spring suspensions. The Germans tested the tank in the Soviet Union under the Treaty of Rapallo, agreed between the USSR and Germany in 1922 under high secrecy and security. The testing facility used from 1926 to 1933 was named Panzertruppenschulkammer, located near Kazan in the Soviet Union. The location was a joint testing ground and tank training ground for the Red Army and Reichswehr. It was codenamed Kama from the words Kazan and Malbrandt because the testing grounds were near Kazan and Oberstleutnant Malbrandt was assigned to select the location for testing. Leichter Traktor, Light Traktor, was a cover name for all 3 medium tank designs produced there. In the early years of World War II, it was used as a training tank. Although these designs were not used in actual warfare, they gave a good intuition on how to build tanks when Germany had previously only made 1 official tank, the A7V, and this design led to the creation of the Panzer I. The T-26 tank was a Soviet light tank used during many conflicts of the interwar period and in World War II. It was a development of the British Vickers 6-ton tank and was one of the most successful tank designs of the 1930s until its light armor became vulnerable to newer anti-tank guns. It was produced in greater numbers than any other tank of the period, with more than 11,000 units manufactured, giving it the title of the most produced tank during the interwar period. During the 1930s, the USSR developed 53 variants of the T-26, including flame-throwing tanks, combat engineer vehicles, remotely controlled tanks, self-propelled guns, artillery tractors, and armored carriers. 23 of these were series produced, others were experimental models. The T-26 and BT were the main tanks of the Red Army's armored forces during the interwar period. The T-26 was the most important tank of the Spanish Civil War and played a significant role during the Battle of Lake Quezon in 1938, as well as in the Winter War in 1939-40. Though nearly obsolete by the beginning of World War II, the T-26 was the most numerous tank in the Red Army's armored force during the German invasion of the Soviet Union in June 1941. The T-26 fought the Germans and their allies during the Battle of Moscow in 1941-42, the Battle of Stalingrad and the Battle of the Caucasus in 1942-1943. Some tank units of the Leningrad Front used their T-26s until 1944. Soviet T-26 light tanks last saw use in August 1945, during the defeat of the Japanese Guangdong Army in Manchuria. The T-26 was exported and used extensively by Spain, China, and Turkey. Captured T-26s were used by the Finnish, German, Romanian, and Hungarian armies. The tank was reliable and simple to maintain, and its design was continually modernized between 1931 and 1941. No new models of the T-26 were developed after 1940. The Char D-1 was an interwar French light tank. The French plan of 1926, calling for the creation of a light infantry support tank, led to the development of the existing Renault NC-1 prototype into the Char D-1. 160 vehicles of this type were produced between 1931 and 1935. There was a pre-series of 10 vehicles and later 150 standard vehicles were built. Until 1936, the vehicles were fitted with Renault FT turrets because the intended cast ST-2 turrets were not yet ready. The ST-2 turret was armed with a short 47mm SA-34 tank gun with a coaxial 7.5mm machine gun. The hull carried a 7.5mm MG in the bow. The type did not serve as an infantry support tank as originally intended, but as France's major battle tank of the early 1930s, it was quickly phased out in 1937 because of its mechanical unreliability and relegated to colonial units in North Africa.